The latest addition to the arsenal of N-Track Studio Effects is Lo-Fi, the Swiss Army knife like tool you can use whenever you want to get your audio signal to sound vintage, old, or just plain bad. It lets you easily add many types of noises, including vinyl, white, pink, and brown noise, to add new flavors to tracks and productions, and you can even get your audio to sound like it came from an 80s 8-bit computer. You can access Lo-Fi in the latest version of N-Track Studio on iOS, Android, Windows and Mac. Simply update the N-Track Studio app in App Store or Google Play, or download the latest desktop version from ntrack.com. In this video, we'll be using N-Track Studio for Mac. For this video, we've prepared a simple two-track project using loops from our Blue Jazz Loop and Sample Pack. You'll hear a piano line and a drum brush part, which combined with the Lo-Fi plugin should work great as an overall vibe. To open the plugin, we'll go to the mixer and select N-Track, then Lo-Fi. Let's look through the plugin modes. The default mode in the Lo-Fi plugin is vinyl. This mode emulates the noise from a vinyl record player. The generated output is never the same, and under the hood, vinyl mode has been created from a combination of four layers, each of which can be tuned independently to customize the sound. Let's hear how it sounds on the piano part. We can adjust the level of the vinyl noise with the gain setting on the right of the plugin. We can control each of the four layers that shape the sound of the vinyl noise. Let's start by selecting the crackle tab. We can adjust the gain level of the crackles, the density, which affects how often crackle artifacts appear. We can also adjust the thickness, meaning the presence of low frequency components, and intensity. By boosting the gain, the bright thin events which characterize the crackle sound are more present. The same settings are available for clicks and pops tabs too. Clicks sound wider and thicker than crackles, and pops are characterized by a low frequency thump-like noise. We can also manipulate the static layer of the vinyl sound. If we boost the gain level and adjust the color setting, we can hear the continuous noise part of the sound being shaped. Color affects the spectrum of the noise, changing from darker to brighter. We can also change the frequency of the hum sounds in the vinyl, which could be useful if matched to the key of a project or intentionally away from the key of the project to create tension. Let's add the Lo-Fi plugin to the drum part. If we click on vinyl, we can change the Lo-Fi plugin mode. White, brown, and pink noise are random noises with different shapes in the frequency spectrum. Let's select brown noise. Brown noise is low frequency sound without some of the harsher high frequencies found in other noise colors. It's often used to improve relaxation, focus, and quality of sleep. Let's compare it with the pink noise mode. You can hear that the pink noise sounds a little more like rainfall, again characterized by low frequency components, but combined with some gentle noise in the high frequencies. Let's now select white noise mode from the Lo-Fi plugin. We can hear the sound more evenly spread across the sound spectrum, with mid and high frequencies much more present than the brown and pink noise. For our drum track, let's use some low frequency brown noise, turn down the gain, and see how it blends together with the vinyl mode we previously added to the piano track. Sparse and Velvet noise modes also have a density parameter. Sparse noise set at maximum density is almost equivalent to white noise. The density parameter for Sparse and Velvet noise represents the average number of pulses per second. If the density is lowered, imagine that there will be more silence in between the pulses. A musical application of sparse noise could be to create irregular pulse trains, and we can see a preset in the Lo-Fi plugin that represents this. If we compare the sound of both with our drum track, sparse noise tends to sound smoother, while velvet noise has a rougher quality. Both Bitcrush and Samplerate crush modes process an input, meaning that, unlike the other lo-fi modes, you won't hear a sound without an audio signal coming into the plugin. Bit crushing reduces the number of bits used to represent a sample. It lowers the quality, adds distortion, and is often used as a creative effect or to get a vintage digital sound. In the Crush tab, you'll see two settings, bit depth and wave shaping. Let's use a loop from our saxophone pack to illustrate how the sound changes as we lower the bit depth value. The wave shaping parameter adds extra shaping depth. The higher the wave shaping value, the more noisy the overall output. If you want to get a pure bit reduction, leave wave shaping to zero. Instead of affecting the bit depth of the signal, sample rate crush reduces the sampling rate instead. Let's hear how adjusting the sampling rate parameter affects the sound. The sampling rate is reduced in a purposely rough way, so instead of resulting in low-pass filtering, you also get an aliasing component, which typically results in a metallic sound. Again, the wave shaping parameter is the shaping depth, and the higher the wave shaping value, the more noisy the overall output. We'll use effect automation features added in NTRAC Studio 9.1.5 to automate the bit depth parameter in Bitcrush mode and progressively morph our saxophone track. We'll enable the record envelopes icon visible on the lo-fi plugin, play our track, and adjust the bit depth setting as the track plays back. Once complete, we can see the parameter movement automation has been captured and plays back automatically. We have a specific video for the new automation features, which we'd recommend that you check out. Link is in the top right of this video. So let us know how you're getting on with the new lo-fi plugin in NTRAC Studio, and if you have any questions or comments. Also, please give this video a like, as ever subscribe to the channel so that we can keep it growing, and ding that notification bell so you know when our next video is out. Until the next one, have fun making music with NTRAC. Cheers.